listen, I am burning prophetically tonight. I'm going to lead worship, but I'm a seer. I'm prophetic. Ever since I've been spirit-filled, I've never been to your campus before. Oh my Lord, you've got a huge destiny. Somebody say yes.
Yes.
But only half the people that you're going to touch are here right now. Pastor Mark said 422 this morning was the count by the ushers. And we're heading for 900.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. No, that wasn't good enough.
Yes.
I said we're heading for 900.
Yes. Yes.
East Side rules, Jack. Come on.
Yes.
I said we're heading for 900. Yes. Praise God. Hosanna. Hosanna. Hosanna in the highest. Yeah, yeah. Hosanna. Hosanna. Hosanna in the high. Sing it again, yeah. Hosanna. Hosanna. Hosanna in the high. Yeah. Yeah. Hosanna. Hosanna. Hosanna.
Hosanna, Hosanna.
you
open up my eyes to the things unseen. Show me how to love like you have loved me.
The heart of Jesus for sure, Lord. Let's put our hands over our heart and make it our prayer. Heal my heart.
Heal my heart and make it clean.
Hear our cry tonight, Lord Jesus.
Will you open up my eyes to the things unseen? Show me how to love like you have loved me.
Well, many
praying. Release a greater light of heaven, God, a greater revelation. Let's pray over the 90-minute radius around this campus right here. We're releasing future, and we're crying out to the Lord, God, for the next dimension of future destiny. If you have a prayer language, start using it right now. Pray in English, pray in Spanish, pray in French. We thank you, God, for the greater release of light, light, light over Granite City, light over Alton. They're going to come right down 203, God. They're coming right off of 270. They're coming right in here, God. We're calling in the burnt stones. The next wave of salvation has got to start praying right now. Come on, you guys, pray. This is a level jump night in Jesus' name.
Yes.
I'm going to do all four sections of the prayer of Jabez. I want you to repeat them after me. Bless us, Lord, indeed.
Bless us, Lord, indeed.
Expand our territories.
Expand our territories.
Your hand of favor is on us now.
Your hand of favor is on us now.
And you keep us from evil.
And you keep us from evil.
Bless us, Lord, indeed.
Bless us, Lord, indeed.
Expand our territories.
Expand our territories.
Your hand of favor on us now.
Your hand of favor on us now.
You keep us from evil.
You keep us from evil.
We're going to sing it, and then we're going to pray it. Oh, you bless us, Lord, indeed. Expand our territories. everybody. Will you bless us, Lord, indeed? You expand our territory. Your hand of favor is on us now, keeping us from evil. Will you bless us, Lord, indeed? You expand our territory. Your hand of favor is on us now, keeping us. Do that much again. Come on, everybody. You bless us, Lord, indeed. You expand our territory. Your hand of favor is on us now, keeping us from evil. You bless us, Lord, indeed. You expand our territories. Your hand of favor is on us now, keeping us from evil. Now put both hands straight up in the air and let them fall on the shoulders of the people in front of you or next to you, and start praying. This church receives the blessing of the Father tonight. Heavenly rain is in this sanctuary tonight. It's a level jump in blessing. Come on, pray all four parts of the prayer over Pastor Harold, who's still here tonight. Harold and Ruth, God, we thank you. Start praying to bless them, Lord, indeed. Use those words. Bless them, Lord, indeed. Expand their territories, God. Everybody prays. Everybody gets a blessing. Every family, every single parent, every child, teenager. The blessing reign of the Lord. The blessing reign of the Lord. The blessing reign. Your provision tonight. Your prayer, your promise, your provision tonight. Calvary Life. Calvary Life jumps to the next level, God. This is a night of level jump in the spirit. High speed for high places, Lord. Yeah, yeah. Hey, Mike, bring me a nine-fold. There's something happening in the spirit. Yes! Yes! Oh. Yeah! Let's sing it out together. You bless. Oh, you bless us, Lord, indeed. You expand our territories. Your hand of favor is on us now, keeping us from evil. Oh, you bless us, Lord, indeed. That is awesome. Your hand of favor is on us now, but keeping us from evil. You bless us, Lord, indeed. You expand our territory. Your hand of favor is on us now, but keeping. Come on, one more time. Bless us, Lord. Here's what I'm going to do. Come here. I'll take it. Jill, come up here with me. Get the handheld. I saw Miss Ruth. Help her come up here. Just keep playing, you guys. Just keep flowing. Yeah, that's cool, man. I got to change my battery, but... I want you to... just stand with her, Mark. Come stand with her. Saying to you, it's harvest time It's harvest time, and this church has a huge coming destiny, yes or no?
Yes.
No, I've never been to a church. Well, first of all, most people can their Sunday nights. Most people don't even meet in St. Louis. They don't meet anymore, which I'm not saying that's good. But don't can the nights of worship and everything that makes us spiritual. So tonight, I'm going to have two of the ladies of the house. Jill, I want you to think with me for a minute. Well, Mimi, step up. I need a young girl who's really a spiritual woman, under 25 or so. I don't know who that is because this is my first time at your church. The four of these ladies are going to pray, and we're going to agree as touching. Here's the four items: light, wisdom, future, and destiny. You can call her forward. You call her. Yeah. That's right. I saw her sitting out. What is your name? Andrea, come on up, girl. Join the. These are the four musketeers. Praise God. Now, these are all warriors or warriorettes, yes or no, in your church, man.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, just so you guys know, I've been in ministry 38 years. I'm 58 years old. You know, people say, well, you don't look like it. I said, well, I don't want to look like it. But I've been in ministry a long time, and this counts. The reason that these words, faithfulness and harvest time, are on me because of Harold and Ruth. We're calling in the harvest. We're calling in the harvest. Been here 53 years in the church. Dude, I mean, let's hear it for Harold and Ruth. First of all, thank them. I mean, bro, thank you. Look at Ruth, man. Bro, I need the handheld mic. Get the handheld mic. Bring it up. And we're not going anyplace for a minute because we're praying light and wisdom. This church, I'm telling you as a prophetic errand boy, which is what I've been for the last 35 years. I'm telling you, this church is getting ready to ramp up. I just happened to say it. I asked Mark what the usher's count this morning was. I didn't know what size your church was before I got here. He said 422. How many are glad for over 400 coming to a church anywhere in a Granite City? All, come on. But it's not enough because we got to build a bigger launch pad for all the kids under 28. You're gonna see more youth are coming. You have a good allotment of youth. I see what's going on here. I'm from Destiny Church. We're 40% under 30. We are a youth-based, youth-driven church. I know what I'm talking about. It took us 5 years to get to this place where we stopped separating youth from adults in the minds of the adults. Like, we have young people on our worship team. They do ushering. I mean, they're in our prayer room. They're all over. Even our tweeners, our 8 to 12-year-olds, are active in ministry at our church. Now, that's a little far out for some people, but our teenagers really get it on. One day, a guy said, hey, you know, that girl, she's 14. Should she be playing violin on the adult platform? I said, bro, don't move. He was in the center aisle at Destiny. I said, bro, don't move. Now, I want you to look at our platform. It's all concrete. I want you to tell me if you see the word adult anywhere on that platform. That's a mistake. He says, I get it, bro. I'm never going to bring it up again. I said, because if you do, I'll shoot you. No, I'm just kidding. That ain't right. But I want you to say it with me. Bless us, Lord, indeed. Expand our territories. It's happening right now while we're saying it. Your hand of favor is on us now. And you keep us from evil. I want you to give the mic to Ruth first. And Ruth, I want you to pray a blessing over this house. Pray whatever blessing. Now, she didn't know I was going to do it. Hold it up close because we're getting the blessing of these four ladies over this house.
Lord, we thank you for your blessings tonight. We thank you for everyone that's here. We pray that you would bless their lives. Give them wisdom, God. Don't let them fail you in any way. But Lord, bless them and help them in every way. Lord, lead them by your Spirit. Show them thy way, O God, that they may walk in it. Lead them by your Spirit at all times in everything that they do, God. Be sure that they know the way that you would have them to go and be in the height of your glory in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
We declare the destiny of the Lord upon this place. We say that this is the house of God, where the city is coming to this place and all the surrounding areas. We speak the blessing of the Lord upon Calvary Life Church. We thank you, God, for the promises of your word, for the prophetic words that have been spoken, and we say, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Let your will be done in us. Purify and cleanse this place, that we are coming forth as pure gold in the name of Jesus, that we might be a reflection of you, that your light would fill this place, that those that drive by this church would know that the presence of God dwells here. You are mighty to save. We glorify and bless your holy name.
Now let's sing that prayer. The city is coming here. The city, the people are coming here. From the highways and the byways, they're coming to Calvary Light. Calvary Light. Oh, the city is coming here. They're coming from the highways and byways. They're coming to Calvary Light. And they're coming. Come on, it's a prayer. This is Jill's prayer. Oh, the city is coming here from the highways and the byways to Calvary Life, Calvary Life, Calvary Life. We say the cities are coming here. They're coming from the highways and byways to Calvary Life. You said purify ourselves, God. You're doing it. Come on, one more time. The cities are here. Coming here, yeah. They're coming from the highways and byways to Calvary Life, Calvary Life.
Father God, we just speak a blessing over Calvary Life Church. God, we speak that this place is a beacon. God, raised up in this community. God, you will raise your light forth, shining forth, God, that all men will be drawn to you, God. God, we speak over this house, God, a place of signs and wonders, a place of miracles, God, a place where healing, physical, emotional, spiritual healing, God, a place where the prodigals are coming home to, a place where the prodigals are coming home to, even now, God. God, let the drawing power of your Holy Spirit be felt here, God. God, we'll accept nothing less, God, than your best, God, to burn a fire within us, God. We just ask, God, for your Holy Spirit, God, to be poured out upon this house, God. God, we receive your Holy Spirit in this place. We call it down in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Call it down in the name of Jesus, Lord.
Else but the best in your spirit, nothing else but the best in your spirit, and Calvary Life, Calvary Life, Calvary Life, nothing else, well, nothing else but the best in your spirit, nothing else but the best in your word, and Calvary Life. Come on, you guys, keep pressing in, we're not done yet. This is awesome. Here we go. Well, nothing else but the best of your spirit, nothing else but the best of your word at Calvary Life, Calvary Life, Calvary Life. Sing it again. Well, nothing else but the best of your spirit, nothing else but the best of your word at Calvary Life, Calvary Life. Come on, one more time, declare, prophesy. Nothing else but the best of your spirit. Nothing else but the best of your word. And Calvary Life, Calvary Life, Calvary Life.
Father God, Lord, I just pray, God, for your blessing to just pour out upon this church, God, in this city. Father God, let this city turn back to you, God. Let this city be a city on our knees for you, Father God. Lord, I pray, God, that people can just be so acceptive of whoever walks through the doors, Father God, whatever their situation in their personal life may be, God. I just pray, God, that you will just touch each and every person who walks through this door, each and every person that is here tonight, Father God. I just pray, God, that you will just come, God, and you will just move in such a mighty, God, in such a powerful way, Father God. Lord, I just pray, God, that you can continue to just let us burn for you, Father God. Lord, I pray, God, for this generation, God, this rising generation, God. I pray, Lord, that they will just start seeking you, God, be a city, Lord, and they'll just seek to be known as the generation who falls upon them. Not the generation of drugs, alcohol, whatever, God, but the generation for you, God, and the generation of you, God, and your love and your might, Father God, and your power, God. Let this generation be raised up, raised up, Father God, Lord. Lord, I pray, God, that you raise up Ruth and Esther's, God. And I just pray, God, that you will just rise, God, and they will just be so seeking upon you, Father God. And I just pray, Lord, that they will just go after you, God, and they will just run the race, God. Lord, and when times get rough, God, instead of turning back to what they want to do, God, I pray, God, that they turn to you, Father God, that they turn to you, Father God, because you're the only one who is going to mess them up, Father God. Lord, I pray, God, that you will continue to just move, God, in such a powerful way in this generation, God.
We're receiving this generation with the fresh oil and anointing. We're going to sing it that way. Andrea's prayer song. Say yes, Lord. Wow. Wow. All right, you're going to high five your neighbor and say, dude, you're a huge history maker right now. Give him a high five. Turn and say, you're a huge history maker. You can make your way back to your seats. We're going to teach you a couple new songs. Oh, give me a hug. What do you think you're doing? That was awesome. Miss Ruth, give me a hug. I said, Ruth, give me a hug. She goes, well, you know how it is, brother. I do know how it is. I've been doing this for a while, but not as long as Ruth. How many appreciate Ruth? She's Amen. Beautiful, man.
Amen.
I told Pastor Harold, when I grow up, I want to be like you.
Yes.
He said, all right. This is a song from the prayer room in Kansas City. We're going to keep that in our hearts. You know, Mark, whatever prayer meetings you have, that's a little bit how we run our prayer room. Our church in St. Louis, destinychurch.com, my son-in-law, Jim Stern, and my oldest daughter, Jessica. I can't claim I'm 29 anymore. She's 34. She just had her birthday. I have four lovely granddaughters, 8, 6, 3, and 1, all in a row from Jim and Jessica, and I have a grandson. So I have five beautiful grandchildren. I love them. But at our church, we do 24 hours of prayer a week. What you just saw happen, we'll do quite often, where we have different people come up and start praying. And then what they're praying, we usually base it right off the scripture. Because I know a lot of people in this room know the answer to this question. Isaiah 55, if you sing and pray the word of God, it will not return. This is a church that knows the word, bro. A lot of newer churches don't know the answer to that question, Joe. But you can tell, I mean, this is what I look at the governors and the governesses. I mean, the people over 40 and 50, we're still cruising, we're going for Christ. And we're not afraid of pierced body part tattooed kids coming to our church. That's all right. I'll say it again because we're going to get an amen on that. Listen, us freaky people from the 70s, you can't freak us out anyway. We already did drugs. We did alcohol. I mean, I'm not proud of it. But, dude, you know, all the pierced body part tattoo kids, they think there's something. Go, dude, I was doing that back in the day. Shut up. You don't know nothing, man. It's all right. Anyway, what you just saw happen is, like, we'll pray. Do you have, like, a regular prayer meetings weekly, Mark, that you do here? At 6 a.m. and stuff, man, you know, you might consider, the best off night for most churches is either Monday night or Thursday night, that you might get some of your intercessors together with a bunch of kids under 25, and they could start at 8 and end at 9:30. You could start at 6 and end at 7:30. That's pretty close to work. People drive a lot around the bi-state area. But I would encourage you to think about maybe even occasionally run 1 month of Monday night or Thursday night prayer meetings supported by music and pray and sing the scripture. It's the coming thing for sure, bro. It'll help missions. And, you know, is Andrea in your youth group or in a young adult group? That's what I'm saying, girl, all day long. Have you ever seen prayer like this before? Yeah, I'm just saying she knows how to do it, man. And then when you put all the you can't stop the train on that. The devil hates this stuff. When you worship and pray, he can't stop it. You know, God the Father made sure he gave us stuff that the enemy cannot stop. If you choose to worship, it becomes unstoppable. If you choose to pray, it's also unstoppable. Well, your worship team said, if I don't do this song tonight, I'm excommunicated. I sent them some song. No, they didn't. But they said, we love this song. We wait for you. We wait for you. We wait for you. If you can bring these overhead lights down right in my face down, so that'd be awesome. Come into the room. It's a night of worship. I'm not really a superstar. Jesus is beautiful. Thank you, bro. We wait for you. Yeah. We wait for you. Wait for you to walk into the room. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory come down. Shekinah glory come down. Standing in your presence, here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory come down. Sing that again, here we are, yeah, yeah. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory come down. Shekinah glory come down. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory come down. It's our prayer, Lord. We release the fullness of your Spirit. Shekinah glory come. Shekinah glory come. Release the out of your seat and come to the front right now. We're going to anoint people with oil tonight, James 5. If there be any sick among you, call for the elders of the church, and they'll lay hands on you and anoint you with oil. And God will raise you up. Jill, come pray with them. Come on. Any of your prayers, if you need prayer any way, shape, or form, or healing tonight, come on up to the front. It's raining in the sanctuary. I see it's raining in the sanctuary right now. It's raining. Power of the Lord. Power of the Lord. The balm of Gilead is in this house. Ushers up here in case these people start falling. I'm serious, man. Healing rain in the Lord. Healing rain. The power of an awesome God is present here right now. Healing rain, Lord. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Healing rain. Yeah, yeah. Healing. Just stretch your hands out toward him right now. Come on, you congregation. Stretch your. There's power in the Spirit here, right here. Yeah, power of saying it's not too late. It's never too late with the Lord. If you still need prayer, any way, shape, or form, I love the anointing oil. I'm telling you the truth tonight. I go to churches all over America, especially on Sunday morning. I call for oil and they don't have any, Joe. I go, what in the world? We're spirit filled, dude. Wow. Isn't this originally a Pentecostal Assemblies church? That's what I like. No, this is real, man. This is real. We pray for people at the altar. It's such a beautiful thing that power is released. Somebody say, I get it. Come on, somebody say, I get it. Oh, that's all right, man. Now say, thank you, Jesus, because we want to thank him for it. I'm going to do a song tonight called Faithful to the End, and I'm going to dedicate it. I rarely do this, but I'm dedicating this song to Harold and Ruth. And you guys are going to start praying about harvest time, harvest time, harvest time. There's no way that the Lord would have wasted ever 1 second or 1 minute or 1 hour of their lives, 53 years in ministry. Man, that's a long time. It's harvest. I'm talking coming, driving over from St. Louis and Baldwin, where I live. I'm going, Lord, the word of the Lord, he says, well, release my voice. You got to tell him to start releasing my voice, which I'm going to do. I realize you guys get out, you know, about 8:30 or so, but I want to do this song. And Harold and Miss Ruth, thank you for being faithful. I told Mark before the service while I was meeting, is this your boyfriend over here? What happened, man? Well, he's your boyfriend and your husband. For how many years have you guys been married?
68.
Wait a minute, I gotta sit down. You said 68. Come on, you guys, you gotta put your hands together for that. Oh my Lord. Hey! Oh my God, bro, wow. Wow, my mom and dad are at 64, but I didn't know anybody more than that. Wow, no, you guys, this is such a blessing. This song comes from the prayer room in Kansas City. A lot of the songs that we're seeing right now moving through America, I'm not sure what the low end is on that, but they're coming from the prayer room. How many have been around since the late 70s or mid 70s? Let me see. And when we're doing scripture songs, how many have been around since the 70s? And of course, let's go 80s. How many have been around since the 80s? And we're still here doing it because the Word of God works and stuff. But we see there's a run. Songs will be written in a certain style for an era. And then in the 90s, we got smart. We started singing about our emotions. I don't know why we did that, but we need to go back to the Word, right, guys? No, we need to sing the Word of God. Well, it's coming back through Jesus culture in Redding, California, but also the prayer room in Kansas City. It's Kansas City IHOP, the International House of Prayer. And I'm dedicating Faithful to the End. He is faithful to us. And the faithfulness that's over this house, Mark, you can call in a harvest just on what your mom and dad have done. And then if you look at the other people that have sown, the finances, the prayer, how many of you are intercessors for this church and have been through the year? Let me see your hands if you're an intercessor. Yeah, come on. I mean, I know who you are anyway. That's right. Bro, you're a good-looking man, bro. How old are you? Hey, the guy at the glass, how old are you, bro? Yeah, you. 84. You are 84. What have you been doing? You've been running or something? What have you been doing, bro? What is your first name?
Joseph.
Joe. You and Harold. I said, I'm going to grow up like both of you. Are you 86, bro? This is awesome to have these kind of people at church. But this is real. So this song, Faithful to the End, it talks about how Jesus said, I'll be with you to the end of the age. If it gets really hard in America, I'm not running for the hills. I'm running to the Lord. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
That's right.
It could turn out to be really hard the next few years. I don't really care because I'm going to serve him. People say, well, Kent, what is your eschatology? The study of the end. I said, I'm a pan-millennialist. They go, a pan-millennialist? Well, I've never even seen that. I said, well, that's because it's all going to pan out in the end and I'm going to be here serving God. Man, that is good right there. That should. And the worship team, just relax for the first time through. The promise of your coming light, it burns so brightly in my mind, and all creation groans and waits. The Lord's coming back again, isn't he? For the dawning of that day. promise of your coming light. It burns so brightly in my mind, oh, and all creation groans and waits, yeah, yeah, for the dawn. Justice in your heart, you've got a sword upon your side, and oh, we'll see the glory of this man. You've got fire in your eyes, and you're jealous. Sing that again, learn it tonight. Oh, and you will come. Justice in your heart. Well, you've got a sword upon your side. And oh, we'll see the glory of this man. You've got fire in your eyes. And you're jealous for your bride, 'cause you're faithful to the end. You're faithful. Going down. I know this scripture so well, I really don't even need my Bible. I realize you get out at 8:30 or so, but and I tell you this, Mark, we had talked about doing a whole worship weekend. We just got to figure that out. I mean, you guys are deep worshipers. I don't go to churches. I can't host. What I do full time is I do Friday nights of worship and intercession, 7, 8:30. I train on Saturday, 9:30 to 12. Saturday night becomes a seeking, soaking meeting. We have some of the most awesome things happen. And then I'll stay Sunday morning. And I, if you know, I'm out traveling, I fly home on Sunday afternoon. I'm back in our prayer room. I'm actually in our prayer room 2 to 3 hours a day, 4 days a week. And you know, I've led worship for a long time, August of 74. But I tell you, the prayer room has changed me. It's intensified the flame of the Lord. Like, this is a lot more, there's a lot more passion now. I mean, I'm talking about it in my personal life. And so Psalm 29, I always ask, because when I was 30 years old, I'd been in ministry for 10 years. From 1974 to 84, my first church in New Covenant, actually, my youth group, 1974 to 76, went from 75 kids to 1,500 on Saturday night, every Saturday night in New Covenant over in Maryland Heights. And that's what I grew. We had our adult church went from 300 to 3,000 in the mid 70s. And we had waves of the Holy Spirit, waves of worship. We had miracles. We didn't even know what we were doing. I mean, we were like charismatic and hadn't been, you know, been in the Word that long and learned it and all that. But it was an awesome beginning. But this word, I always, when I was 30, well, Mark, the reason I started teaching on worship was people came to me, even the first couple years, and said, why are you running these songs together and how do you do that? Because they were doing hymns that were all separate, you know, back in the day. And, you know, some hymn style stuff is still around. That's good if it's a hymn style church. But it's time to move on to, I mean, do contemporary Christian stuff or scripture. And the reason I started teaching, and then they said, and when you get done singing the song, how do you keep playing? You know, I mean, it's not that hard to understand. Of course, I didn't get saved till I was 19. I wasn't spirit filled till I was 20, Easter night of 1974. When I was 30, 10 years into church staff ministry, I also pastored for two years. That church is called Southgate now in South County. It's still there. It was called Victory Fellowship. And Integrity Music flew through St. Louis looking for, they told my best friend at the time, I'd led him to the Lord and pray if he'd be filled with the Spirit. They said, we need a man that can come to the studio and do in the studio what he does live. He said, well, he lives right here in St. Louis. And that's how that all happened. And I'll tell you, Joe, I didn't want to do it. I prefigured it out, Mark, that if I do this, thousands of people will know my name, the voice, the anointing. It's going to be a huge responsibility. And I found out years later, All Hail King Jesus, which some of you guys would have had, that came out in 1984. They said over 800,000 copies of that went around the world because it was the free giveaway tape. You know what I'm saying? Like, and so it's kind of crazy. But when I was 30 and all that was kicking up and I left church staff ministry to start the worship ministry, I said, Lord, are you changing my calling? Is there something I need to know now? He said, well, first of all, this ain't changing. You're my prophetic errand boy. You go where I tell you to go and you do what I tell you to do and you say what I tell you to say and things will be great. And if you don't, they won't be great. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't have any, like some of these guys, these TV evangelist cats, I go, that's not of God. And, you know, I'm not naming names, but listen, I can't watch some of it. And Carla, my wife, goes, like, we got DirecTV, God Channel. I mean, some of this stuff comes on, you go, that's not of God. And Carla goes, how do you know that? I said, there's one reason I know that. Did you ever see Jesus act like that in the New Testament? Oh, does that still count? Oh, I guess that still counts, doesn't it? Somebody say amen. And I'm not putting them all down. Some of them are cool, but some of them are not good. The second thing he told me, I'm 30 years old, and this was very personal to me. He said, I want you to teach my body how to intermingle praise with prayer and worship with intercession. Now, there weren't any books on it that we knew of at the time. There weren't a lot of spiritual dads around or nothing. But he said, I want you to teach my body. He didn't say my people or my church. I mean, my church, it would have been cool as well, or my people. But he says, I mean, if the Lord's speaking to me, teach the body of Christ. Think of this, how to intermingle praise with prayer and worship with intercession. And so what I'm going to do tonight is just release the beginning. Like Arnold said in The Terminator, I'll be back. We'll have to figure that out in the future, but I got to drop this as a seed of a word. If you guys start praying about the voice of the Lord being released on the east side, up and down Mississippi River, if you start actually praying and then start seeing it released through your worship team, I mean, we got some of it right now. You've had a level of voice of the Lord. Psalm 29, if you got a Bible software program, New King James or New American Standard, Psalm 29 to the Hebrew people. It's amazing how much Gentile people don't know this stuff. I am a Psalms specialist. I'm a psalmist, but the book of Psalms, I've spent my life in it. I know a lot about it. And the Psalm 29 to the Hebrew people, it's called the Psalm of Seven Thunders. They actually call it the Psalm of the Seven Thunderings of the Lord. Now, why would they do that? Because verse 3 said, the voice of the Lord is upon many waters. The God of glory is thundering. The voice of the Lord is upon or over me. The God of glory thunders. And verse 3 through 9 of Psalm 29, it'll tell you the seven things the voice of the Lord does when it's released. Now, I got to tell you, I've sang all my life. I was raised on country music, bluegrass, years ago, flat top guitars. My folks are from the country in Missouri. I mean, they're from Prairieville, Painesville, Whiteside, Eola, Missouri. I mean, they were country people, and I get that. So, and then I didn't play any music at all I didn't know anything about theory until 19. I went to the Black Junior College, downtown St. Louis, Forest Park Junior College. I was saved, but I wasn't Spirit-filled yet. But by that spring, I got touched by the Holy Spirit. Then I realized he had sent me down there to really understand Black culture. I mean, I met a lot of people, didn't know their dad. I mean, that was all like, you know, I was immune to that. Then I went to Webster University in Webster Groves. It's one of the highest rated musical theater, music departments, repertory theater in the world. And I graduated from there and I studied music. And so I was a vocal major. And I remember my first vocal teacher looked at me at CASA, the Conservatory of Arts, and said, Kent, you're really a great singer, but my God, what rock did you crawl out from under? I had a twang this and a twang that. You know what I'm saying? It was Midwestern. By the time I got my second teacher, she actually, with tears in her eyes after I'd been with her a year, she says, Ken, I'm going to beg you to do something. I said, girl, hold up now. I was already doing worship. I spirit filled. She goes, would you please sing opera till you're 35? And when you come into your full voice. Women stop growing almost totally by the time they're 26, 28 years old. I mean, I know, you know, girls, but I mean, all the nasal cavity. And then men, by 32, 35, their voice will finally settle. This is like a classic guitar, acoustic guitar or something. And I said, she was a good Presbyterian lady. I didn't want to hurt her. But I said, listen, you may not get this, but opera has zero eternal weight, and I won't be doing it because I'll be doing worship in the presence of God. And she got it. It took her a minute. I mean, she said, Kent, your ability to sing. And the voice, I have a really powerful voice. But if you go to Nashville and get your vocal cord scope, which they do, you know, Faith Hill, all the great singers you've ever seen, American Idol people, they go in there with a video camera and it is as gnarly as it gets in there, dude. The inside of your, I mean, there are two little quivering muscles and you go, I'm pretty minuscule, dude. I got really small vocal cords. People might think I'm a great singer, or Sandy Patty back in the day, or Keith Green, are all the great, are American Idol when people watch it. But guess what? These voices don't compare to the Psalm of Seven Thunders. When the voice of the Lord starts being released, listen, stuff's going to be shaking and baking, man, right there. When the voice of the Lord is released, and we'll just kind of walk through them. Go ahead and, well, first of all, two kinds. Your body is 75% water. The voice of the Lord is over many waters. He's right here, right now. The voice of the Lord is over, some translations say it's upon many waters. Well, what percentage of the earth's surface is water? Does anybody know? It's 75 to 80%. So the voice of the Lord, I'm saying literally, is upon the waters. Somebody say amen. Go to verse 4. The voice of the Lord is full of power. This is what I got to say to worship teams. You guys are so bunch of lightweights. Like, I've done this so long. Like, I'm supposed to be an authority in this now. And they call me to conferences, and I teach major conferences. You have 5,000 people there, all this stuff. And I've done it for many years. But I said, you guys, your voice is even at rehearsal, worship. But when you get up there, you're just not that big. You're just not that strong. But if you would start praying as a worship team, God, start releasing your voice through our voices. Start releasing your voice through our drummer on the drums. Start releasing. You see what I'm saying? Then we go beyond some scrawny little worship team. I don't care if you got 18 or 8 or whatever. I'm so done with the human nature and our ability to sing and tweak people in their ears, but we're not moving their heart. I'm not up for that anymore. I never did that anyway. I couldn't stand that stuff. I have never, ever, I've been singing in a band since I was 13. And I told you I got saved when I was 19. I've never been performing, never. I hated performance. We would do live stuff. And I mean, we could do all sorts of stuff. And it was just always out there. And even as a worship leader, it's been that way. We go to verse 4. The voice of the Lord is full of power. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. This is why a man on Sunday night at Calvary Life will come forward at the end or in the middle of worship and say, I want to give my heart to Jesus, because the voice of the Lord is so full of majesty, it will cause him to bow over at your altar. Many will see, this is a Psalm 40 church. I already told you that. Some of you didn't hear it. But I'm going to say it again. This is a Psalm 40 church. You better go look it up and read it for a week and pray it, because many will see, based on what the Lord is doing here, many will fear or revere is the word we replace it. They're going to have awe of God and put their trust in him because of who you are, representing an almighty God whose his voice is full of power and his voice is full of majesty. I went on a moose and caribou hunting trip in Alaska. I've hunted all my life. I know how to use weapons. It's, you know, it's all good. And, you know, it was really, really peculiar because we went, I went to Anchorage Christian Center. I did a worship week, and then we flew to central, it was Whitefish Lake in the center of Alaska. I mean, this wilderness, dude, it's pretty scary. I mean, you break your leg, you ain't getting out right away. It's going to take you a while. Well, it was the best of times and the worst of times because the river was flooded. It's supposed to be the greatest fishing ever. I mean, all the different grayling and trout, whatever they have in there. And then we got in the trip, we got caribou. We actually shot a moose and couldn't find it. The moose was up 7 foot of water. And then we realized by the fifth day, we had 8 days. The guy that scheduled the trip, who's on the trip, there's four of us in 9 foot Zodiac boats with little outboard motors on the end of it. It's the coolest story ever. I mean, this is absolutely true. I don't exaggerate. He looked at the map and realized he miscalculated the river miles. We're going to float and motor for 60 miles over 8 days. It was 160. Anybody, you guys ever been on a float trip? And Dave Rabisky, who's the worship leader, this guy's mountain man. He's a white Russian guy. I mean, he's been there all of his life. And he says, we're just going to have to get in the boat and take off. We won't make it to our pickup point. The pickup point was called Sleet Mute. Sleet Mute in Aleut language. It's the sharpening rock in English. I tell you, we started motoring out. We ran out of gas. Eskimos gave us, I mean, you know, Native Alaskans gave us gas. We eat peanut butter. We ran out of food, and they just kept helping us. And my hands were cracked open from wet and dry. I mean, we had to get through sweepers. And so when I got to Sleet Mute, we got out of the boat, and Dave said, Kent, God bless this dude. This is the hardest trip. This is a Native Alaskan. And they had one little shack in the middle of this village where they did have a runway where a larger plane was going to pick us up, larger meaning 8-seater instead of 2. And I said, I'm going to try to call my wife. I didn't realize what happened to me on the trip because I picked up the phone and, you know, you hear the static. I said, there's no way I'm going to get through to St. Louis. I'm Sleet Mute, Alaska. Sure enough, Carla picks up the phone. And I heard her voice, and I burst into tears. Dave said, Kent, we could have been seriously injured. I mean, God covered us, and I'll never do that again. When I heard Carla doesn't sing. Well, she sings. She doesn't like being up front. She doesn't, you know, she doesn't sing on a mic. Carla's tiny little voice. Is this your wife, bro? Dude, you scored. How'd you get her to marry you? What happened? You lied, bro? Oh, you should have said, I prayed, dude, right there. What is your name? Becky. Bible school bride for the nations, bro. I've heard all these stories, man. Here's what everybody say, voice. Because the voice of the Lord is powerful. You're going to start praying. I'm just going to end right here because it's 8:30. I like this clock on the wall. It's 8:36. But the voice of the Lord is coming to this church. I believe as you pray it, I mean, it's the help of the Lord that where you haven't stalled out. I mean, you've had really good growth. You've built buildings. How many are blessed with what God's done for Calvary? I mean, I'm blessed to be here in this sanctuary. But it's time for the next level, yes or no? I said yes or no.
Yes.
And we started it tonight. There was a prophetic seed dropped right in the middle of this lake, and the circles are going out from here. Something very, very powerful. Now you're going to pray, intercessors, maybe do some prayer and fasting about your future and your destiny. We're not just hanging out, taking up time and space. We say no in the name of Jesus. Now I need somebody off the CD table to grab me, speak to the dreams, the brown cover, somebody, and Skyview is the blue cover, and History Maker has a little boy in front of the maze on it. As you go out tonight, here's what I do. When I'm on the road, we raise our own support on the road through offerings and stuff like that because I train interns year round. I told you I'm 58. My wife turned 60 last summer. 15 years ago, we made a commitment to release the music and ministry of the next two generations. Everything that you buy tonight, half of it goes to scholarship our interns. Like, I believe in multiplication. I'm not getting any younger. We're not burning daylight. And everybody over 40 said, absolutely. We're making hay. The farmer's turn while the sun is shining. So I'm going to tell you the top three CDs you could get as a church. And your worship team already has six of these. So as you go out tonight, if you'll start learning these, we've had great breakthrough. This one is the brown cover, Speak to the Dreams. That's my son-in-law in the corner. What happened when we did this two nights of worship, the first night we got an hour into recording and we had prophetic words dropping about dreams that had died are going to come back to life. We had an altar call. It's unbelievable. The next night it happened with visions and delayed prophecies. So Speak to the Dreams, you'll totally dig it. This is one of our all-time favorite albums. We're getting ready to do a second one. This is called Skyview. There is no singing, no lyrics. There's really not any loud music. This is a devotional album that's done with keyboards and pads. It's one of the coolest. It's called Skyview because we're looking from his perspective. It's got the blue cover on it. The other one, because this is what this church is, this is called History Maker. The band Delirious went 17 years. They just disbanded, I think, 2 years ago now. We took that one song about 5 years ago. We did three nights of worship about building, making history makers. It's some of the most powerful stuff. If you buy two, you get one free. They're $15 a piece. You can buy these three shrink wrap together for $30. So you're buying two, you get one free. And come on up, Pastor Mark. We'll close with Desert Song if you want us to do a song. I love you, bro. You're something, man. You're messed up, but you ran into Jesus, dog.
Holy God, where's the band at? Let's go, people. Come on, get that band up.
Amen. Is it okay to talk?
Can I,
yeah, right now? Amen. We've been talking before, and one of the songs that we sang prophetically was, this house will be called a house of restoration. You remember that?
Wow.
We were talking about that, and we've spoken that over this house. We want that to happen. Years ago, Dad, I remember as a young child hearing Dad saying, this is a church of deliverance. You remember that?
Oh.
Church of deliverance. Those that have heard this, I believe that God is doing that, delivering and setting a destiny upon people's hearts and lives. And we want to be a part of all that God is doing. Is that right? When you're singing, you're not just singing a song. You're singing the word of the Lord over this house. Not only over this house, but throughout this atmosphere. It changes. It changes. It changes the community. We want people to have a hard time going to hell as long as they live in Granite City. We don't want them to be able to just be free to go. We want them to have to go through Jesus and through the cross, and we want to lift him up throughout this community. Amen. Sing us out, will you? Go ahead.
Okay, this is a song again that's been out for about 5 years, and it's been 2008. It got really hard in 9 for a lot of people financially, spiritually. I mean, a lot of stuff is going on. So Brooke Frazier, the song Hosanna we did earlier tonight, she wrote this. Well, this is my prayer in the desert, yeah. When all that within me feels dry, yeah. This is my prayer in my hunger and need. My God is the God who, somebody say yes on that, provides. And this is my prayer in the fire, yeah. In weakness or trial or in pain, there is a faith fruit of more worth than gold. So refine me, Lord, through the flame, yeah. And I will bring praise, I will bring, come on, get up to your feet. No weapon formed against me shall remain. And I will rejoice, I will declare, for God is my victory and he is here. And I will bring praise, I will bring praise. No weapon formed against me shall remain. And I will rejoice, I will declare, God is my victory and he is here. Now we're going to sing about the battle. He's our God in the battle, yeah. Is my prayer in the battle when triumph is still on its way, and I am a conqueror, nowhere with Christ, so firm on your promise out in the harvest. And this is my prayer in the harvest where favor and providence flow. I know I feel to be emptied again, the sea I've received, I will sow, and I will bring rain, I will bring rain. No weapon formed against me shall remain. Awesome. I will rejoice, yeah. I will declare, God is my victory and he is here. And I will bring rain, I will bring rain. No weapon formed against me shall remain. Song should be over by now, but it's not yet, because she wrote a bridge. It's so cool. You want to do it? Oh no, let's skip it, let's forget it. No, you want to try it? Okay. Yeah. It goes like this.
And all of my life, in every season, you are still God. I have a reason to sing it out. I have a reason to
thank God. Say, dude, you're a huge history maker. God bless. We'll see you this week at Wednesday.